Common data elements, part 3 of 4. NIDS, common data elements, their goal is to develop standard definitions, code lists, and instructions for common data elements so investigators can collect them consistently across studies. The items mean the same thing across all studies, so it can be reusable, it can be compared, aid in creating research, help in the data sharing plans. The NIDS Common Data Element Project included a working group of experienced clinical research assembled by NIDS. It's a dynamic standard that allows it to be evolved over time. And there is a link that's available in the slides. There is different levels of common data elements in the NIDS project. There is general core. It's a small subset that are to be collected on every study, any study. A general CDE, a data element that can be consistently collected across studies. Demographics, physical exam, informed consent, enrollment, adverse events, they're general common data elements. Disease common data elements, they're specific to data elements for identified diseases by NIDS. So they have common data elements for epilepsy, common data elements for stroke, common data elements for Parkinson's disease, common data elements that are specific to traumatic brain injury, and there's specific common data elements to spinal cord. And they add different disease types based on studies and identify a set of common data elements. Supplemental, highly recommended common data elements. It's collected in clinical research studies, but whose relevance depends on the study design. So the type of clinical trial based on the cohort, based on the type of research involved. Supplemental common data elements, a data element which is essential based on certain conditions or study types in clinical research studies. In most cases, these have been used and validated in the disease area. And then exploratory common data elements. It requires further validation. It's filling in current gaps. They're testing out its use, understanding it, but it has value, but it requires validation to be used. And so NIDS has a catalog. This catalog is a directory of the available common data elements in NIDS. Users can search the catalog to isolate a subset of common data elements. Like I can pull all the ones that are specific to stroke. I can pull all the those specific to a specific disease, a specific research type, a specific level of common data element. And so this is their main page. It shows the disorders, shows their announcement, how to cite common data elements, and we'll have a screen for that. It identifies the different diseases that common data elements have been defined for, and then provides different items for each. And again, there's a link on the slide for you to learn more. You can build a form or a CSV file. You can build a form that you can utilize for your study. You can identify which common data elements you want to utilize. You can identify the name. You pick which ones you want to pull. I marked a few here: birth date, ethnicity, gender type, medical history, condition that utilizes the SNOMED CT code. It provides a definition, how it's classified, what type. So you see the core ones, see some supplemental ones that I've added here. And then you can, this is a list of more, but by selecting them, you can create your form. Here is based on ALS functional rating scale. So this identifies all of the components of that scale. In the middle one, you see specimens, so for lab test. And on the right side, you see vitals. So these are the common data elements that NIDS uses for their studies. And it's available for anybody to utilize these code values, these common data elements, and understand what exactly they're measuring. And so you can build a form or a CSV. Here's an example of the CSV. It identifies the code value, the form that you're creating, what the variable is, the definition, all the components that were available in the category when we were pulling it. And then they identify how you should cite the use of NIDS common data elements. So they want you to use them, but they also want you to cite them. So it's known that it was utilizing the NIDS common data elements. So it's easy to pull out that it was used. They identify how you should cite it in publications and presentations, as well as in clinicaltrials.gov. And then here's NIDS common data element in use. So to show that we're actually utilizing common data elements at the NIH. So you see epilepsy, you see the different project numbers, the project names, where it's being used for headache and multiple sclerosis, Parkinson's. It shows the different clinical studies that are being used. Some are NIH intramural, and some are multi-site studies being used.